Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Europa Universalis 4, an early Reich as Prussia. As you can see, Bohemia has expanded last episode pretty heavily. There's some wars going on over here with Meath. War, did England lose territory? Yes, they did. Interesting. Yep, you're on your way. Good job, dude. All right, let's continue. Prussia has, or Castile has now announced me as a rival, and we are working on getting rid of this coalition. Would love to attack Bohemia, honestly. Peace treaty doesn't end until 3 more years from now. We need manpower and troops. We'll grab another infantry. It's getting to the point where we're going to start building cannons and only cannons for this stack, but we might start building another stack or split this in half and put 2 stacks walking around. But we'll see. We did get 5 heavies, so that's good news. Treasury is freaking spiraling out of control with 14% tax base. I mean, I really don't care. I'd rather gain the inflation right now. Because as bad as that is, it's not that much money. Plus, it's going to go down anyway, so. All I have left is Saxony to annex. And I can't annex you for a couple more years, right? Yeah. For next year, I can annex you, but you're not going to be ready to. I can add you 70, 25 points, so I go to 77. Maybe we could. You already have military access, so it doesn't matter. Annexing them would be really good, though. We'll get us at least one of our cores that we need. Sachsen. Oh, gives us two of our cores. So Sachsen and Thuringen would be nice. And we can move in pretty quickly. Yeah, money is ridiculous right now. Can I build any more boats? Got 28 ships. No. Could build buildings. Ferrara has a bad air. Okay, I don't like the Castile rivalry. So my enemies are getting. Oh, actually, my enemies aren't that bad. I did rival France, so I could try and get a marriage with Burgundy, who actually got an heir already. Damn. They're actually pretty damn close. I would like to get them added. If we wait till the end of the year, it might actually still be enough. Possibly. And I might attack you. I do need Rostock, so I might make a claim on it and then attack you for it. Are you still my rival? I don't believe so. No. Urbanization. Lose ducats and gain 3 base tax. Or get cost. No. Hang on. What I'm gonna need is to lower taxation. Oh, it's not gonna be enough. Can I ask you for money? Yes. Okay. So let's max out your army maintenance again. Mean, more base taxes is just ridiculously good at this point. 0.1, 0.12. And with a cheaper build cost, we're in pretty good shape as well. So we'll continue rolling with that. A little bit more base tax. Does that mean a little bit more troops? Yes, it does. Very nice. So our front line is 31 right now. We have only a front line at 27, but the next tech does not even add front line. The next one won't be until 14. I need to get some diplo points coming in though, like badly. Influence ideas, it would be nice, but I don't want it yet. It would really be nice. I really need the tech, and I really need a couple of techs, so. Do we focus this knowing everything else is going to go down? I think we can. We really need the extra 3 points a month, or 2 points a month we get from this. So, let's get a couple claims on Muscovy, more importantly. We're going to do it for Ostrov. We probably do want to get one on Polonsk if I can. No, stay there. You, however, I can get on Hamburg and not have to worry. Okay. Come back from Hamburg, by the way. Fabricate one on Rostock. Important centers of trade. Probably just Lübeck itself, right? I guess. Not Lübeck's not even an important center, but Hamburg is. So if I get Hamburg, that's it. And I do need Rostock, so we'll look at this. If I were to attack you, though, you call the coalition, which right now cannot happen. And then all of the other people. Well, I can call Sweden, Scotland, and they do it, so. Okay. Do I want any more trade? Not really. I mean, some of these provinces, like this one's still a pretty good one to have, and this one, but making enough ducats for now. We'll go 0.1 here. That's a pretty good pricing. And then from now on, we're going to be doing taxation. You know, 0.1's for sure. 0.17 in memo. And these three, basically, are the ones we got to do. That's going to bring us in so much money. Although we're already bringing in a crap ton. We're just basically recovering. We do need more manpower, and that is a thing. We could build. It's just manpower everywhere. Eventually, we'll probably need it. By eventually, I mean we're going to need it regardless, but Casile. You're not really developed for manpower, but it's fine. You are making 18 ducats, or 8 ducats a month, which is pretty damn good. And you are fighting your rebels. Damn it, I want to fight you. But not as long as you have a coalition that will freaking defend. And unfortunately, that is the case. Speaking of coalitions, though. Like Salzburg. I could probably improve relations enough to get rid of you. Probably also improve relations to get you to like me enough, right? Very possibly. Clan nobility has now expired. That puts him up at 74. Very nice. I do have a claim on Ulm that I could attack. I just don't want to attack him and Bohemia joins. Let's put it that way. Denmark has no king. And no allies. So, we could use that to our advantage. Venice's trade league has just disbanded. I want you to disband, dude. But I need to get your prestige so damn low. Granted, generalship just went away. That's okay. 9 ducats a month. Holy hell. And I can still make at least one state. Or 2 states officially, so. I could, but I'm not going to bother too much. Yeah, I could get that lower development, but it's fine. Let's build some barracks, I guess. I don't know. I need more manpower, but I really don't want to do it that way. Let's instead work on ducats. 0.17 in memo is ridiculous. 0.15, 0.13, 0.12, 0.15, 0.1, 0.1. I have about another ducat I can get just by spending some ducats. And this is just going to keep going up, because autonomy is decreasing across the nation. You know, look at the highest autonomy base. It's Kassel, and then Ostenburg, Polok, Wischau, Wins. So these guys are finally under 50%, and they're going to keep dropping down to zero as long as they're not given an estate. So you're making me 1.5 ducats. You can probably make me about 2 ducats a year or a month. Okay, yes, we will wharf up. Well, I mean, we just lost points. Make slander merchants more morale. Nah, let's just gain the autonomy increase. That's fine. Since we've been getting autonomy, can I actually create more ships? No. More troops? No, but I'll go one more infantry up. Doesn't hurt. That might also push the coalition out. And eventually we're going to get more land to get one more infantry, so. Of course, I can always do a building that just gives us infantry. We can tech up. I will tech up because this is going to be plus 5 discipline and the massed battery. So, let us mass our artillery in a single grand battery. Its destructive power will blast a hole through enemy lines. Plus 10 combat ability for cannons. Which means I get plus 10 on everything except infantry. I get plus 20, which is rather nice. And those cannons will wreck holes through. And now we are 7 years ahead of time in military tech and no way to tech up real quick. Of course, we're only getting 6 points a month, but that's fine. Who are my rivals? Castile, Lithuania, Bohemia. Come back from you. I don't really need anything other than Rostock from you, so. Let's go to Castile and insult them, because they can't reach us really anyway. That didn't give me any points. Lithuania I have a peace treaty with. I can still send them an insult, though. Did I already insult someone, or is there a reason I'm not getting these points for this? Meh. Alright, well. Annoying, but not too bad. We'll continue building on you. I could build on you, but for now, I mean, getting these three would at least expand my nation pretty heavily. And probably cause a coalition, which I don't really want. Poland's gotten so weak. Saxony's king died. Well, hey Saxony, how's it going? Should probably be improving relations with my vassal instead of trying to get more claims against this guy. What would I want anyway? Is there an important province around here? Development rise, I mean, Stralsund and Wismar are pretty good. Wismar more for the ducats. Finance the printing, minus tech cost and idea cost, that's pretty good. Yeah, let's do it. I'll take out a loan. Wait, how old is my king? King is currently 56. You know what? I'll do it. Because he could live for a while. He could also die tomorrow. Okay, so on you, if I were to fabricate on you. I mean, obviously, Lubeck is the one I want to do, but I can't. So, like, there's no way. Truce with Lithuania and Bohemia has just ended. That's not good. Okay, Bohemia, I could attack. Switzerland and. Switzerland's the one province minor, so I'm not really worried. Ulm. How much of an army does Ulm have? Compared to Bohemia. Oh, probably. Checking it this way is easy. 13k, so that's not really that big of an army. Bohemia has 26. I could meet them in battle and then still fight the other guys. How many claims do I have on you? I have your entire border. I need at least this one. So let's come back from you. You're not allied to Switzerland, so that's fine. You're guaranteeing the independence of Poland. You're allied to Poland, so that's fine. If I declare war, we can do this. We will call you in. I think I still have enough favors. And we will do it for no tech, although we might not actually take no tech. And let's move. Yep, recovering economy failed. Hey, go figure. Declared war on Bohemia. Very true. That's exactly what I did. Get the Pope to like us. Plus 25 Diplo points. That's pretty good. Increase prestige, I could probably do too. I could have done Conquer Silesia, which would have been smart. Let's get the Pope to like us, though, even though we're not, obviously, his religion. Sweden I've called into war, so they should be joining us pretty soon. Let's get the war going. Damn it, there's two forts here. What? Well, we'll see what we can do. And heck, I still might be able to get them. Okay, so I fabricated a claim on you, right? So let's get Stralsund, even though I don't really need it. We'll claim it anyway. Because why not? Okay, let's get the ticking war score. And my question is, are you under their control or not? 580 admin points. Holy hell. And of course our general dies. So let's go to the nobility, grab a general. A siege leader, pretty good. There's the Bohemian slash... Oh, so freaking Ulm hired troops. Interesting. I need to do, like, best guess. I'm sorry. This is ridiculous. I'm getting, like, no notifications. Alright, Sweden. Bring your troops down here. You're going to have a drop-off in Oslo. I cannot offer you fleet basing rights, but that's stupid, if you ask me. Okay, yeah, it is flipping back because this fort is considered separate, which is stupid. Ponons is a farmland. Oh, I gotta go all the way around. Really? Did I outnumber you 2-1? Of course, if they come up here, that might be an issue. That is exactly the way they're going. Alright, let's pull back to Danzig. Did not expect them to turn around. I should have waited a bit longer. Damn, they have a lot of troops because of frickin' Salzburg. Of course, the Emperor won't defend us because this is an Imperial War, or a war within their territory. And I can't even attack you, so I should just stop building, but for now it's fine. Yeah, it's BS, but we can try and get the little one stacks, little by little. This is woods. I got out and managed to get out. Quit trying to attack me, dude. I can't believe they could hire those troops. That does not actually put them high enough. Karl the First of Austria. Do I have a marriage with you? I don't. Let's get one. See, if you die, a member of our house succeeds now. Which I would appreciate. I might claim your throne if I get the chance. I don't think you have super dangerous allies. No, Muscovy would be the scariest, actually. I can't do much about this. I'm gonna have to let them siege on a lot of this. If I pull out, this should not flip, right? This isn't a double zone of control crap. Yes, it is. That's such bullshit. Send me one troop. Come on. You go all the way down there, man. Try and take that fort. I'll main attack Berlin while you're at it. This is such crap that this is double fort shit. Okay. Come over here, and then maybe we attack Berlin. Cede Thuringia to Prussia. Renounce their claim in Core. Renounce the claim. Okay. Gonna have to take care of this. This should be maybe not an easy win, but it should be a win. Oh, yeah. And that was an actual stack wipe of the Ulm and Swiss armies. I can still tech up. It's admin, but I'm 6 years ahead of time. Holy shit. I guess we just power into Berlin, right? At least until we get to 20. Oh, I can't do it anymore because of the base tax. God damn it. Burn down some admin, although I do know we will have to tech up. Getting a little bit more money doesn't hurt. Okay, so we defeated a good portion of their army. Not a great portion, but a good portion. 7 war score from that battle. Let's unseed our territory. Truce with Saxony has just ended. It's woods here. I really don't want to fight that. But if you're willing to come and help me, we'll go fight them. Actually, I think you're going to go straight to Prague, aren't you? I declared this war on Bohemia for conquest. How pissy are these guys going to get? Pretty pissy. If I do this and that, yeah, they're going to be rather upset with me. We can wait a bit. Maybe I can get some points ticking down. Okay, you're going in. Let's go. No, stay here. Keep an eye out. Get throw our troops in battle. There you go. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Damn it. Alright, they're gonna have to help me. I did not actually mean to move there, but is it at least woods? No. And I am crossing a river. Come on, guys. Move this way. Although we might win this battle, funny enough. We just have so much. We have an entire tick of morale more? How? Tradition at 14.3? What? You're tech 12. I'm tech 12. Tradition is at 57 points. Holy shit. Well, I guess that makes sense. Yeah, I think they're going to come and help us, and if they do, that's great. Felt hats means the price of fur goes up, I think it is. That's pretty good. Let's get to Prague. I might be able to kill them. I think they'll go to Prague. They might go to Moravia. And if they... Yeah, they are. Shoot. I already had moved into Prague. Well, that's not bad. Saxony winning that battle, that is. Come on, get the stack wipe. No, but where are you bouncing to? Prague? Or Eger? Probably Eger. Maybe all the way to Ulm. Now that I think about it. Yeah, it looks like they're heading all the way out there. Okay. So not worry about it then. Let's go back in and re-grab Glau, so that way I'm not taking extra points. Half of you there. Half of you here. One of you there. One of you there. And then you siege out our territory, and then we'll move accordingly if these troops start moving. And it does appear that that might be the case. Okay, you're heading that way, that's fine. Go away from me. Okay. Let's move in here. Give them support. They should have stayed at home. Nah, give them support. We'll pay 10 diplo. Pozan is now under our control. Very nice. I just want to get no tech and then start sieging these down, actually. Luckily, they are helping out quite heavily, so. Can I get the conquer this territory mission while I'm at war with the owner of said territory? That's actually something I don't know. Spain has no king. By the way, there's Spain. Yeah, there's 27k. If Salzburg would get out of this freaking war, someone want to declare war on Salzburg? Austria, come on. Just don't take anything I actually want, you know, like Munich or Augsburg. You can take Salzburg. It's the capital. Yeah, Lithuania's gearing up for war. Or at least making claims for war. I mean, by doing this, it gets me a good amount of provinces I do kind of want. I could also break your alliances or break Ulm's alliances, because I should have some war score against you, right? No. According to you, I don't, because I guess I don't have anything sieged. Break your Bohemian alliance. Break your Salzburg alliance for sure. You can keep the Palatinate one, it's not that big. That would give us a peace deal until 59, which I could actually support. But we might have to wait it out a bit. Okay, they're coming to me. So what I might have to do is, like, drop a troop. And can I move in here? Not easily. Great. Yeah, that's still the best general, so. Let's go in. Reinforcements are on their way, guys, don't worry. They have more cannons than us, but right now cannons aren't going to make much of a difference, sadly. Thank you. Okay, you do have siege value, but it's fine. I say you have to be able to walk, so. Are you coming to deal with me? Hang on. Okay, you're heading south to that fort. Good. Come on. We're moving around. Get in there. Maybe I can stack wipe those three. Highly doubt it, but maybe. Okay, did luckily get in there. Supply shortages are nice. Let's weaken up Bohemia a bit more. And I'm debating, do I even take anything in this war? Like, I know I did it for a conquest, but could I just break their alliances? Like, break your alliance, maybe not with Switzerland, but with Ulm, for sure. And then in 7 years, attack them again for territory because they shouldn't be able to get back their alliance. I think we could. Yeah, let's do it. This weakens them quite a bit. It also weakens Ulm quite a bit. Also means maybe I don't have to fight the frickin' Salzburgian army. Now, I did call Sweden in, but how many favors do I have with you still? And now that I only have to fight Bohemia, maybe I don't have to even worry about it. I got 37 favors. We're perfectly frickin' fine. I'm making a favor every year anyway. Let's get our troops together. Let's recover our manpower. We are negative 11k, so we might be able to maintain a positive. Let's call you back. Let's pay off our one loan. We're still making like 5 ducats a month, 6 ducats a month. And we'll wait. All right, well, that was a very uneventful war, honestly, but I think overall, breaking the alliance there was pretty damn good, and it gets me ready to annex Saxony. Because it did give us defended our provinces and a little bit extra. So let's improve relations with you. Get you up high enough. We'll get the extra points from you soon. Very soon. Actually, in 1 more month, I think that'll be enough. Maybe we get the mission for conquering too? That'd be nice. We're gonna go for Wishmar on this one, although I don't necessarily want it. And let's call you back. Can I get any more claims on you? No. So I have all my claims on all your neighboring territories. That might change once I get that, but we'll see. Rival of our rival? Who's the rival of the Pope? Bohemia. Makes sense. I could take an idea. It'd be diplomatic. We are still trying to catch up diplomatically, so no, that's not gonna happen. Incorporate Saxony. I mean, I do want to do that, so let's just click on that. The extra reputation would actually be pretty good. And I'm just trying to cause the coalition to go down, basically. And this is going to cost me points a lot, but ten years, according to you. I'm assuming it's because I have no diplo reputation to speak of. I'm minus three right now. Wow. And I will be for another 3 years, so that's fine. I'm still making using 4 points a month at this rate. So we're hardly making any Diplo gains now. Our treasurer just died. Okay, that kind of stinks. Don't really want either one of these guys. Can I afford a level 2 guy? I mean, I really don't want to either. Diplo rep guy right now would be good. Let's grab the yearly prestige, because why not? It'll keep us up to about 30-something right now, so that's good. Too many troops, huh? Okay, 8 ducats. That's also still ridiculous. We are recovering pretty heavily. Okay, you can come back. Alright, I already got all on you. I got that, so I might take this for myself. I don't want to release Frankfurt, although I probably could, from Ulm if I were to do it. I could have you return territory to Switzerland. Switzerland, who is currently a free city in the Empire. I'd have to see how I could do this. It's not gonna be fun. Okay, you little shit, are still in my coalition, although you only have 31 points. So let's go back and... I can still improve relations with you, so let's do it. And that should... And funny enough, doing this actually stops them from joining the coalition. So that actually was a very, very good play on my part. Verdun, Breslau is no longer able to be claimed. Well, that's annoying. You I want to get. Let's just start fabricating on you again. It's going to cost me a while to get points, but it's fine. You're still my rival, and I didn't really take anything, so I guess that's an issue, huh? It's alright, we'll build up. We got time. Okay, manpower-wise, I do want more buildings. I guess 330 there is pretty good, and 31 and 330. So these three will get built over time. We're only using 200. We should have enough manpower, funny enough, to cover ourselves for a while. Yeah. Now we're actually gaining manpower every month. Only 5 points, but we are gaining. Postal service, huh? I don't really want this tech, but tech 13 is... I was going to say, is it a ship tech? Or is it just another increased... tech, like an increased tech. No, I'd rather have the nobility a little bit more upset at me. Yeah. I don't really care, guys. Sorry. I can probably get you out of this coalition if I get you up to 50. Which, I mean, makes sense. 2.7 a year. Are you any more likely to marry me into me now? Really close. I could probably get it if I increase relations again to max. I'm a heretic, though, according to you, but that's fine. I would love to get a union over you. Might not happen, but I would love it. Okay, you have 52 points. Let's remove you. Now let's improve relations with you. Back to max. Maybe I can get the marriage. Maybe I can get the alliance. That would also be very good for us. Not same religion. I think if you went friendly, I'd get a 40-point switch, and that should be enough. How much is it for friendly? Is there anyone even friendly near me? Probably not. I can check it on mine. I'm friendly with them. Oh, but I can't check to see. Oh, well, whatever. Okay. Palenque is no longer possible. Where the heck is Palenque? Oh, over here. Salzburg has now left the coalition. Very nice. Thank you. That should weaken the overall coalition, so we might start seeing dropouts, and if we do, we can probably move. I need to have a sink for admin points, but I don't really have one. Lower inflation, but it's going down regardless, so I really don't care that much. Muscovy has started to become westernized. Alright, we can use that to our advantage if Muscovy starts getting weaker. So could the Ottomans, although apparently they've been maybe losing territory. Yeah, let's take the admin hit. I don't like doing that. I should be using it for development, but it's fine. Okay, are you any closer to marrying into me? You're really close. You're one tick away, and we should be able to get it. And then I might be able to get an alliance after that. We're gonna annex Saxony pretty easily. Noble rebels, I don't care. Hey, more trade power. That's gonna be it for this episode, though, guys. Next episode, which will be very shortly. Excuse me. Okay, you're no longer emperor. Oh, you never passed the prismatic sanction, and your king died. Well, that sucks to suck, don't it, Austria? Alright, well, we'll see what can happen here. Thank you very much for watching, though. Next episode. Apparently, I'm already voting for them. Next episode, we will be dealing now with Austria not being in the emperor and seeing if they get any weaker. Alright, thank you very much for watching, though. I will see you next time. Goodbye.